regulating assault weapons certainly falls within the bounds of the Second Amendment, and so does everything else we're urging. This is not a constitutional question.
Constitution. You know, the right to bear arms is because that's the last form of defense against tyranny.
If there is a step we can take that will save even one child from what happened in Newtown, we should take that step. The belief that we have to have stronger background checks, that we can do a much better job in terms of keeping these magazine clips with high capacity out of the hands of folks who shouldn't have them, an assault weapons ban that is meaningful, that those are things I continue to believe make sense.
In 1964, the desegregation of Jonesboro, Louisiana High School was threatened by local authorities with fire hoses. Four armed black men arrived with loaded shotguns. Without firing a shot, the mob dispersed and the authorities retreated.
You know, I come from a country, as I keep telling these gun rights lobbyists, where we had a Sandy Hook-style massacre in Scotland in 1996. We had, I think it was 16 five-year-old children killed in a school. And as a result, there was a national handgun ban and an assault rifle ban. And as a result of that, there's...
You just having a gun to defend yourself puts us all at danger.
Organizations like the NRA, which are trying to increase deaths by gun in this country.
Violence is always going to be part of it if guns are available.